Hi, I'm out in the Shenandoah Valley in Virginia at Nat Wenger's farm. He's a buddy I hunted with last year. Lots of deer. We're seeing deer everywhere.
Every year, it just seems like more and more keep coming in, so good for you guys.
Well, you manage your herd really well, don't you? I mean, you're pretty strict about what bucks you take off here.
Yeah, well, this week, actually earlier in the week, there was a 130-inch deer taken. We try to keep it within a 130-inch range, and anything that has a deformation or anything like that, we try to take out of the herd.
So if you have a big wide 4-point, you take
it
out.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, you have some depredation permits here too. I mean, you've got to take some of the doe off.
Yeah, right? I have a DCAP tag, which is issued by the Virginia Game and Inland Fisheries, which allows us to take a doe anytime throughout the season, which is really a big help for me, because some days you go out and you might only see a buck or vice versa, but it gives you the opportunity to take either or, so it's really a big help.
The gun I'm going to start out with is a little bit interesting. This is from a company called XP Airguns, and it's their model called the Badger. This is a 40 caliber air gun. This gun is very cool in that the cylinder's been set up to take high pressure. We're charging this up to over 4,000 PSI. It'll go higher. I believe it's rated up to 5,000 PSI. But with that, we're getting 3 full power shots. The gun's interesting also in that if you cock it all the way back, you get full power output. If you cock it halfway, you get lower power. If you're sighting and practicing shooting in closer, it gives you or shooting a lighter bullet, gives you the option for using lower power. Bullets we're going to be shooting from this gun are 185 grain hollow point from Mr. Hollow Point. At 50 yards, it's dead on. 100 yards, it's 2 mil dots in the scope. We're using a center point scope. Then we're going to take this gun out for deer. We'll see how it goes. Can't wait to get out there. I've been sitting here all morning and seen a couple of deer feeding out on the perimeters too far away, 250 yards away across the field. But then a group of about 5 or 6 came in, then they started pouring down off the hillside. I think we've got 9 or 10 does down right in front of us with a few more. Clay, there's a deer coming in. A buck is out there. Points. He gets a walk. Okay, I think she's in close enough. Good hit. Man, she's moving. She's carrying lead more than I thought, but it was a good hit. Yeah. You get like 3 shots. That's plenty for a big game hunt. So we'll let her just give her a few minutes for her to settle down, and we'll go in and retrieve her. So I took this big doe with the XP Badger 40 caliber PCP air rifle. At about 100 yards, close to 100 yards, using a 184 grain hollow point bullet. Put a hole right through her. Hit her a little further back than I intended, so she traveled a bit, but we were able to track her down and recover her. Had a lot of fun with this gun, just out. First time I think it's been used for a big game hunt, and really worked well.
Next week on American Air Gunner, we're traveling to fabulous Las Vegas for the 2016 SHOT Show. This year, it's bigger than ever, and this year, I'm checking out more than ever. Hope the camera guys can keep up. We'll be sitting down at the round table to discuss airgun accessories, and what do you say we get to know our new friend a little better, the airgun scientist, Joe Brancato. We'll see you next week.
Thanks, gentlemen.
Tyler, what
are you saying? Enough good
Tyler,
stuff
I can't
about
believe
you.
It, man. That's good. I like it.
You did well.
Now I know for sure that Tyler likes me.
Yep.
I don't have to doubt that anymore.
Call me crazy, Tom.
You're crazy.
Well, thanks.
Oh, you're crazy, Tom. I'm sorry.